What's up everybody, Tim Vix here and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I got my hands on the new Suzuki Burgman. Does it perform well and how does it stand out of the crowd? Let's talk about it. History time. Japanese call it the Sky Wave, but the rest know it as the Burgman. This maxi scooter is being sold all around the globe by Suzuki and it actually has 6 variants, starting from the Burgman 125, 150, 200, 250, 400 and the Boss 650.
650, yeah? Now I can smoke all those Pulsar boys.
Hold on guys, before you get too excited, let me tell you that India will be getting only the Burgman 125 for now. But that is okay considering the fact that 125 is the second highest displacement engine for a scooter that you can buy in the country. To be honest, in spite of knowing the fact that this is a maxi scooter design, I did not like the way it looks. It reminds me of the guy who hit the gym hard but somehow managed to skip the leg day every single time. I never understood why people were buying it in the first place. Until I experienced it myself. Guys, I have ridden so many scooters and this is hands down the most comfortable scooter that you can buy right now. And since we are on this page of the review, let's continue with the ergonomics. There is plenty of leg room and even the tallest riders will find it comfortable when compared to other scooters. You have an option of keeping your feet flat on the floor or you can choose to keep it in an inclined way, which gives a more laid-back cruising feel. Riding posture is good. Handlebars are placed at a comfortable distance. The pillion seat is pretty spacious and comfortable as well. Overall, you can easily munch miles on this scooter without breaking a sweat. But will the engine support your adventures? Well, the 125cc block is the same one from the good old Axis 125, which means it will not leave you hanging in the middle of your adventure. The engine churns out 8.5 brake horsepower at 7000 RPM and has a torque output of 10.2 Nm at 5000 RPM. Though the engine feels good on highways, it lacks the initial punch, which sadly means that you won't be the first one of the signal. I'm not saying it's slow, but it's not the fastest one either. But I'm pretty sure about the fact that those who are considering buying this scooter will not actually bother about the acceleration figures, because if that was your intention, you would be looking somewhere else. Well, the Burgman claims a mileage of 53 km per litre, but my friend is managing to squeeze out 40 to 45 km per litre in real world conditions. Handling is surprisingly great. I'm saying surprisingly because I was surprised. Though the vehicle looks bulky, it's very nimble and agile. It is very flickable and switches directions almost instantly. During my ride, I came to a junction to take a U-turn and I did not expect the handle to turn so much. That was a very impressive turning radius for a scooter of this size. Talking about size, the Burgman weighs 108 kgs. It is very manageable in the traffic and does not feel intimidating at all. Braking is impressive thanks to the 170mm disc up front and the drum in the rear. The telescopic suspension soaks up the bumps like charm and gives a very plush ride. However, there is no feedback. You don't get any feeling in the handlebars. The handlebar actually kind of feels disconnected, which is scary on highway rides. The Burgman's top trunks also includes its impressive storage space. The underseat storage is big enough to store a helmet and few documents. But apart from that, you get two hooks in the front and also a glove box, which has a charger inside. Keep in mind though that this glove box does not have a lock, so don't leave your phone behind. The digital speedometer is clean, crisp and very informative. So what is my verdict? If you're looking for something comfortable and easy to ride and are willing to sacrifice a little bit on acceleration and riding feedback, then the Burgman is a very good option to consider. Looks is completely subjective and I leave that to you. Priced at almost Rs 70,000, it is more expensive compared to its rival like the TVS N-Torque or the Aprilia SR125. But to be honest, the Burgman is something completely different than those. In fact, there is nothing similar to it in the Indian market at present. Suzuki is just giving us a taste of what a maxi scooter feels like, and boy, it tastes sweet. A big thank you to my buddy Tejas for making this video possible, and thank you to you guys as well for making me a part of your day. I hope you found this video useful. Share it with your friends who are planning to get a new scooter, and I will catch up with y'all in the next one.